on this computer, and then I'm gonna take a screen capture. One screen capture. Yes. So, are you ready? Smile. All right. Let me go and wait a minute. Save that.
Hello.
Good. Yes. Where did I go? Current model issues. Screen September 24, 2020. Current. By the way, I'm not teaching you current moral. Okay? I'm not teaching you morals and ethics. I'm just using the issues to discuss about them so that you learn how to think logically and critically. So I'm not supposed to be teaching you morals and ethics. I hope you understand. Okay, so we go. Now, I have done that. So now I'm gonna share screen. I'm recording, right? Let me check. Oh, okay. Oh, share computer sound.
Teacher?
Yes.
Our friend in our live group said that she was kicked from the meeting. She can't join anymore.
Who did that?
Somehow.
Can't she click and come in again? Click the invitation.
He said that Candy joined because previously removed it by host.
She named San Wan. I don't know.
Oh.
She named Panathon.
We don't know San Wan.
She named Panathon. Panathon cannot join the meeting.
Well, why didn't she use her name with the last ID number, last three digits? I kept telling you.
745.
The seventh class already. No, don't tell me. They have to, she has to do it again.
Please join again.
Join again.
Okay, I tell her.
Guys, because in the last class, last Thursday, some strange guys that we have not, we don't, didn't know who, okay? They joined our class unwelcomed, okay? Because they were not one of our students. And they joined it and they sort of made fun and had a lot of fun, like dancing and singing and laughing. But no, I don't know why they joined and disrupted the class because we're wondering who they were and everything. And PTA asked them who they were and they wouldn't answer. And for a few minutes they left. So I don't want that to happen again. And that's why we need these security measures from now on. Okay. I didn't think that we needed it. But now we need these extra measures and it makes your life a little bit more difficult, but this is because some thought it was proper and okay to just join any classes and have fun joking around. there when we are seriously discussing things and learning about subjects in the program. So did she join again? I don't know. I'm gonna do I have to send her another invitation? I don't know.
In my opinion, you have to create a new meeting. It's a worst case scenario.
My God. And you guys have to come and join again, and we're gonna meet you guys all over again. That's silly.
Now Banathorn can she tell can join this meeting.
Oh, she can?
Yeah.
Okay, all right. So now I can go on with my lesson. So guys, look at this carefully, because again, I'm gonna ask you questions about it. Can you see this? Can you hear the sound? Switch off your microphones, guys.
Think about the generations and to say we want to make it a better place for our children. You know, it's a better world for them. Think they can make it a better place.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. And this place is much brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. And this place, you feel there's no hurt or sorrow. There are ways to get there if you care enough for the living. Make a little space. Make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying if you care enough for the living.
Make a better place. Stop the bombing and stop the war. I have a dream.
You are for me. for me, where we live, for me, for our children, for me, where we live, for me, for our children, for me, where we live, for me, for our children.
Uh-oh. Okay, that's it. So, what is the message of that song? Who can tell me? What is the message? What is it trying to tell us? Rio, I don't see your hands. Ah, Gavelin.
It says make the world better place for the human race.
That's the lyric. Can you expand on it a little bit?
Like,
what does that actually mean?
I think to make the world better place for me is kind of like
how
every human equal.
Mm-hmm.
And like in the movie. In the music video, I saw like Mother Teresa and I saw Princess Diana, I believe, and I saw.
But don't tell me who you saw. The question is, what was that you saw? That what was it telling you? You're saying heal the world. So, can you tell me why we need to heal the world? Maybe to expand on it. Why does the world need healing? But you get a point. I'm going to go to Naramon.
Yes. So heal the world is to make every people in the world with all the different races can live together happily.
So you're saying the problem is they can't live together properly, happily yet. So I'm asking what the problem is that you think. That's why we need to heal the world. So there must be a problem with the world right now. So what kind of problems that you think we should heal? What are the illnesses with this world that you have to heal? At Sadang.
Yes. Mm. In my opinion, I think it is inequality and poverty. It's a problem of this
poverty.
World.
Yes. Now, there is poverty in a lot of places, but what would be the causes, do you think, of the poverty that you saw in my video clip, okay? The first
movie.
Huh? Yes?
Excuse me. Please accept Silanya. She lost.
Oh, okay. Admit.
Thank you.
And Nakhalin, go and change your name and come in again. With our agreement, you put your first name first and the last number, the last three numbers of your ID. Oh, I kept telling you this is not the first time that I've told you to do this. Okay, now, where were we? Yes, I was wondering, poverty is not the cause, you know, poverty is a result, you know, of many wrong things that people do. Poverty results from that. So I want you to go down deep into the root cause of poverty of these people. Did you see, what did you see at the beginning of the video clip? Hemawan. What did you see at the beginning, the very beginning of the video, the music?
The very beginning is like about many problems in
what
this
problem?
World.
What problem? Specific. Be specific.
Mm.
Of course we have. That's why we're going to heal. We want to heal the world. Michael Jackson wants us to heal the world. But I'm going want you to be specific. Do you know what problems exactly we are facing right now? The world is facing right now. Don't think about it, Hemawan, not yet. Not you don't get a point yet, or what?
I think it's terrorism because I saw the 911 incident.
Ah. Okay, so we have people trying to impose their beliefs and their ideologies onto another, maybe. Or they feel that they're being treated unfairly by the superpowers like the US, maybe. Okay? They might not originally be very bad at the beginning, but they might feel that they have been treated badly by the superpowers, maybe, right? And so they thought that they had to do something to, you know, push back on that. So they created all these terroristic acts. Bantita, what was the problem at the beginning of the, you were not watching the movie, the video clip, Bantita?
I saw many people were laying on the bed, like they seemed to be
Who are they? Who were they?
Maybe the Muslim. I'm not sure, like they have something in on their head.
What is the topic that we're going to discuss today? What are the topics? Do you know what we are going to discuss today? That's why I show you this video clip, super great.
War.
War. Yes. So the video clip actually is trying to tell us that the root cause was war, right? It might not be so, but I'm asking you about this video clip. I'm not asking you for your opinion of what you think is the cause of all this problem in the world. I'm asking you what you saw in the movie, in the video clip. The movie, the video clip, whether it's right or wrong, but it was telling us that we had a lot of fighting. We had a lot of protests. You see the street protests shown there. People go, in the streets. And that caused war, right? Fighting. And that causes what? Causes what? As a result of war, Kanta.
As a result of war, then there's...
You saw what in the movie clip, video clip?
Poverty, disease, inequality.
No, no, but before poverty, you have war, and then what happened?
War, and then...
Did you see the ship full of people? Oh, and did you see a lot of people walking? What were they doing?
They immigrated.
Which number... They were doing what?
They immigrated.
Why did they immigrate?
Because they are migrants. Because there's war, so they cannot live in their country anymore.
Because there was unrest, war, and fighting and conflict, bombing and everything every day. Their houses burned down and bombed away and everything. So they couldn't make their living. They couldn't live there anymore. There was nothing to eat because the economy is so bad. So they had to migrate. They become refugees, right? That's the topic we're discussing, isn't it? Pichaya.
I'm sorry for interrupting, but I believe that there are many students that cannot join the meeting right now. Could you admit them now?
The TA will be doing it, not me. I assign this task to the TAs.
Teacher, please take me co-host, please. Again.
Why? I did that already. So where's your name, by the way? I can't see your name. Where are you? Fine. I don't know. Where are you? What's your name, by the way? Sarin.
Siranya.
Siran. Yeah. More. Make co-host. Yes. What about Supatsan?
Father.
You are a co-host, right?
Me? No.
You are a co-host already, right?
I'm not a co-host.
Why not? I made you co-host already.
I cannot accept any students.
Hey, I did that from the very beginning. I'm a co-host. Now you are co-hosts. Okay, right.
Okay.
Wait a minute. Then I go back to participant. What? Oh, how do I, okay.
Teacher, I can join now. I wait for join the class for 10 minutes.
Yes, because there was something wrong with making people co-host. You should be here exactly at 1 o'clock, okay? Because now we have started the lesson and then our attention is no longer with people trying to join. And so if you have problems, we can't see you. And that's why you had to wait for 10 minutes, okay? So next time, try to be there exactly at 1, and then we would be able to get you permission to come in. Asajan. So we were talking about refugees, and that's the topic of our discussion today. You saw the refugees, okay? And you saw the ships filled with refugees. Did you see that? Millions and millions of them try to flee their countries. And that's a lot of problem today. That's why I asked you to discuss this. Now, what else did you see? Now, at Sajan, did I?
I see a people. Hello?
Yes.
Can you see?
Mm-hmm.
At the second half, I see the people that holding a candle and light up. For me, I think it represents about a change that when you want to change the world to a better place, you need to start from yourself. And if you can see when they hold the candle, it's just a small light, but it together is very bright. And I think that means when you start to change the world, you start to yourself. And if everyone do that, the world will much better.
That's very good. I'm giving you 2 points. Uma, you want to add something?
I think I saw Martin Luther King.
Who was he?
He was like an American who tried to move black people movement, so people can have equality. And in that video, I think it was the time that he said, "I have a dream." So I think Michael Jackson is trying to say that people have a dream that we will have a better place for tomorrow. And as Jan said, that we will have to start with ourselves and empathic with each other.
Okay, thank you, Papichaya.
I saw migrations.
Yes, we did talk about that.
Yes.
I asked for more detail. Migrations and then what?
I think I don't have anything to add yet.
Oh, but we talked about migration already. I talked it to Yes, Kanta mentioned that, I think. And so I expanded on that already. You are the...
Yes, I saw Nelson Mandela.
Nelson Mandela, who was he?
He's a president of South Africa.
He was.
Yes.
And then what did he do? Why was he so special?
Because in period of him, he's called for right for black and white in South Africa to work and to go to school, to go to hospital, because in that time, white people, they just want to
they dominated everything, actually, right?
Yes, something like that.
So the Black African people there did not have a lot of equal rights.
Yes.
So, you know, they, for example, it would be more difficult for them to get good jobs, a good position, more difficult for them to get good education. It's hard for them to even say, open an account, a bank account, or to take out a loan, things like that. So they wouldn't be able to grow or live in a good, well, what do you call it? Secured life or happy life, equal to the whites. And then what did he do then?
Like he called for and he have to be in the jail for 27 years.
Mm, 27 years.
Yes.
And then what happened?
And like national, they see about the what happened in South Africa.
How did he
Africa.
Get out of jail then?
No? I'm not sure about it.
How did he get the country to be? But eventually something happened, right?
Yes.
So that there are now more equality, but still, you know, there's still discrimination still going on, not strictly equal yet. So no other people want to say what they saw in the video clip? Anybody else? Did you see? Or what?
And I saw the climate change problem too.
Oh, yes. Where? When was that?
It's the picture of like the penguins on the ice, and the ice was just melting. And there's no place to live.
Okay. Papitaya, you want to say something again because your hand is still up.
I saw wealth gap. I saw scarcity. Where? I saw the babies that died in the beginning.
We talked about poverty and we talked about the cause of it. Can you tell us other causes of these things? Because people dying, poor people are being poor. They are actually the outcome, you know?
Okay.
They are the result. So we're talking about the causes. What other causes can you say that could lead to all these
conflict?
Bad things happening to people?
Is it about conflicts?
Conflicts. Yeah,
yes.
we talked about that already. That's one of the causes.
Okay.
Of people migrating, and that causes it's a very big deal right now. That, you know, it's very difficult to solve. So okay, so nobody else would like to add anything. So let's start our discussion for the first topic. Please come up.
Okay, sir. Can you see it? Is your hand to see my presentation?
But you haven't introduced yourself yet. I kept telling you. The first order of business, you have to tell us who you are.
Okay, before I introduce myself and ourselves, we are going to show our role here. So can you see this?
Can't hear anything though.
Can you hear the sound in the clip?
No, we couldn't hear anything.
All right.
I hope you're not going to show us a video clip explaining what consumerism is. Because that's what you have to tell us, not to get us to watch the video. I want you to show me events, something happening. Some event, some scenario that will show us what consumerism is, not for us to listen to someone telling us what the consumer.
Okay. So this time, can you hear it?
Okay. I still can't hear the sound though.
Are you making it? What can I do? Because I don't know what.
You didn't share the sound. Share the sound.
You have to check box share computer sound.
Share computer sound.
How can I do? Because it's the first time I share this the sound.
But you know, I told you to check.
First. Okay. I can.
It worked.
It worked. Okay, let's start.
You stop sharing.
So boring. What should I do?
Can you hear?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Shopping? That's a good idea. I think I should find something I want to buy. Oh no, my money is gone. But I have to buy this new collection bag. It's so beautiful and perfect for me.
Hello, Buzz.
Hi, Dove. I have something to ask you to help me.
What's wrong?
Well, can I borrow your money? I will take it to buy a new collection bag.
Okay, of course.
Oh, thank you very much. Then I will return back to you soon.
Okay, bye.
My money will run out again. But there are only two bags in this collection in the world. However, I must have it.
Again? Hello, first. What's the matter?
Can I borrow your money to buy a bag, please?
Are you going to buy it again? I think you buy it a lot. So is this good?
Definitely good. This is limited edition. There are only two in the world. So I must have it in my collection.
Okay. After this, you should buy less. If you keep doing this, it will be bad. And this time, I will lend one last time.
Okay. Thank you very much. And I will return the money soon.
Okay. Bye. This work is so good. My teacher will be proud for my work. Yeah? What happened first?
Dolph, I have something to tell you. I don't have any money back to you.
Huh? Why not? I have to spend money for my daily life as well.
I really don't have any money. I took all the money to buy my bags. Now I don't have any money to eat.
Didn't I warn you? Buying more than necessary is worse. It's a waste of money and waste of national resource. You are only interested in buying new products. Finally, you have to come in there because that's the worst of it must have. Like this is not good. This time it is considered a lesson for your life. After this, you must be more restrained in buying things. Otherwise, you will be in debt again.
Oh, I see. Thank you for reminding me. Otherwise, I'm bad for sure. After this, I will use the money to buy the right things.
Okay. Okay, bye. So when we buy something,
the end. You have to say the end, not just end, the end. Okay?
Can you see again?
See what? No, no, we don't need to see it again.
Can you see in the middle, in front, right front? Can you see it?
Right what?
Okay, I have to confirm with this, okay. So when we buy something, we must use them with wisely until that things have broken. And they no longer to work and do not to buy things according to current, which is unnecessary because they weren't used the time and they did to waste of money. In the end, we didn't have the money to buy and care for the things.
Don't take a position. Are we going to start discussing if you take that position? You should not take side, you know, because in fact that behavior could be good. So, but we're going to discuss about that. But anyway, why don't you stop sharing now?
Because
I'm going to...
The next slide is...
No, we're going to... I'm going to share my video role play as well.
Yes.
At this point,
next
to get it over with. Wait a minute, Super Chai, are you listening to me?
Okay, stop sharing.
Stop sharing.
Okay. I get it.
I want to get my role play out of the way, you know, because it's also connected with consumerism.
Yeah.
Or I'm going to forget to do it again. Sometimes I forgot completely. So this is now my turn to share. Can you see this?
Okay, I can see.
Pretty woman walking down the street, pretty woman, the kind I like.
I'm so tired today. I've been doing such a lot of chopping, but they are so nice, so many nice things. The clothes are so beautiful. And I bought many pairs of shoes. They're so stylish. I bought some pants too, and a pillow. Oh, everything is so nice. So I spend a lot of money, but that's okay because I have many credit cards. Oh, who's calling me on the phone? Let's see. Hello. Hi. Oh, is that you, Horn, darling? How are you? Yes, I'm fine. You would like to take me out to dinner tonight? That's okay. What time? 6 o'clock? 6:30? Yes, yes. I'll be waiting for you. Okay. See you this evening at 6:30. Okay. Oh, wait a minute. Somebody is calling me on the other phone. Wait a minute. Hello? Oh, is that you, Tiridin? Hi, I miss you so much. You would like to take me to see a film tonight? Oh, what time? I see, 6 o'clock? No. Bye, maybe later. Oh, 9 o'clock, yes? I can make it, yes. I can see you at 9 o'clock. I'll go to the film with you today. Oh, somebody is calling me on my other phone. Oh, hello, who are you? Oh, Dang, is that you, Dang? Hi. Oh, you would like to take me out on a date? When? Tonight? At what time? Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Hello, wait a minute. Oh, hi, hi, is that? Oh, is that? This one. Hello, is that you then? Oh, you're here today. Bye bye, bye bye. I'll talk to you later. Oh, I don't know. Oh, bye bye. Oh, I'm so confused. I have so many faults. But anyway, oh, this shop has so many nice bags. Let me see. Look at this one. Oh, this is a nice evening bag. Oh, with a lot of bling. Oh. What about this one? Oh, this is nice too. More bling, bling, bling. Which one is nicer? Oh, look, that one. That one is even nicer, right? Oh, goes with this dress. No. Oh, which one should I buy? What do you think? Which one should I buy? Oh, okay, I know. I'm gonna buy all three of them. Right? That's okay. So I'm gonna take them off. Okay, so take this cup. Okay. Take this cup.
Sorry, your card was rejected. Your transaction is not approved.
Okay, it doesn't work. So let's try this card. I have another card. Try this card.
Sorry, your card does not work again.
It doesn't work either? That's strange. No, come on. Are you sure? Okay, let's try this one. Use this one then. I have another card. Go and use this one. It must work.
It won't be dangerous again.
No, it doesn't work either. Come on. Oh, how come? That's very strange. What about this one? I have another card. It must work.
Rejected, rejected, rejected.
Come on, I must have maxed out on all my credit cards. What should I do?
Okay, so that's that my role play shows behavior connected to consumerism. Okay, that you have people now buying things that they don't actually need. They need maybe not that many mobile phones, but you know, a lot of people just buy the new
the new
collection again when the new one comes out. Then they just have to buy the new one even though they already have one that works. So they keep on buying the new things and new stylish clothes, more fashionable clothes, or you know, limited edition things. So it's an example of consumerism behavior, and that's what we're gonna be discussing today. So please go on, Super Chai.
Okay, sure.
Most of us live in a culture built on wanting things. An entire system that is based in consuming.
All been raised on television to believe that one day we'd all be millionaires and movie gods and rock stars, but we won't.
Humans now own more than they have ever owned. Instead of buying what we need, consumerism has us wanting anything and everything we can get our hands on. The key to this is advertising.
Advertising has us chasing cars and clothes. Working jobs we hate, so we can buy shit we don't need.
Advertising creates a demand for products, and those products are sold for a profit. And that profit gives people more disposable income to spend.
Advertising is based on one thing. Happiness.
Research shows that although we own more things now than we have in the past, people don't feel any happier than they previously have. This has been reflected in rising rates of depression and anxiety.
The things you own end up owning you.
And at the center of the cycle is capitalism. Some define capitalism as a political and economic system organized around making money.
Let me tell you something. There is no nobility in poverty. I have been a rich man and I have been a poor man, and I choose rich every f***ing time.
So institutions and businesses are structured around the need to make money.
The point is, ladies and gentlemen, that greed, for lack of a better word, is good. Greed is right.
Companies create a demand for products to increase profits and make money. Consumers buy those products, fueling a cycle of demand and profit.
I bought it 10 years ago for $50,000. I could sell it today for $600. The illusion has become real. And the more real it becomes, the more desperate they want it. Capitalism at its finest.
But what does this mean for us? All of this consuming has resulted in mountains of garbage. Fast fashion, for example, contributes to huge amounts of waste, with consumers encouraged to see clothes as single-use items. When it comes to technology and gadgets, companies also add small updates to their products, promoting yearly purchases. Then there's plastic. Each year, the world produces nearly 340 million tons of plastic in the name of supplying cheap materials for consumption. And half of it is single use, with plastic not able to be broken down or recycled, all in the name of consumerism and demand.
We are consumers. We are byproducts of a lifestyle obsession. Murder, crime, poverty, these things don't concern me. What concerns me? Celebrity magazines, television with 500 channels, some guy's name on my underwear.
Okay, so my name is Supachai Ratana Abhishai.
My name is Maita Anam. My ID is 6305747.
I
can't see your face though.
And my ID number
Who was the other girl?
Manita,
I don't
747.
Why don't I see her face at all?
I can see her face.
Huh? I should see anybody who talks. I forgot to.
So my ID number is 6305544. So today we are going to present in the topic consumerism. So what is consumerism? So consumerism is a social and economic order that encourages the purchase and goods of goods and service in ever greater amounts. So it has also been used to refer to something quite different called that consumerist movement, consumer protection, or consumer activism, which seeks to protect and inform consumers by recording such practices as a honest packaging, advertising, products, guarantees, and improved safety standards.
Consumerism is understood as an action where people pushes.
Can you do something so that I can see your face? Because right now I can't see your face. The other girl in the team.
Can you see me?
I can't. Why? Even though when you're talking, why can't I see your face? Can anybody advise me on this? I click view, standard side by side, speaker. Ah, wait, no. Standard. I keep seeing someone.
Whose name? I don't know. Standard.
Standard.
Yes, and then
คลิก standard แล้วไง I click standard
show gallery view
ไหน show gallery view
show grid view ค่ะ show grid view
gallery right now I have gallery view and then how I don't see the thing that says show grid.
View option and then choose standard.
View and option.
Yes, and then choose standard.
I don't have a standard to choose from.
It's the top one.
Huh? Hi, no, view option. This is because someone is sharing, I think.
No, we have standard option. In view option.
But now I can see Manita. For some reason now she turns up.
Okay. Okay, so can we continue
Okay. Alright, go ahead.
Okay.
Consumerism is understood as an action where people push goods more than necessary. It has been around ever since the first civilization. However, it got popular during the Industrial Revolution period, where goods are produced in an affordable price and therefore were able to reach a wider range of people, promoting consumerism internationally. Function and effect of consumerism. First, consumerism has brought a positive effect on the economy. Therefore, it plays an important role in the financial system. It is the main factor of how the economy can have a good cycle. If people only purchase the essential goods, the economy will suffer and it will affect the stability of a country. Next.
Wait a minute. You're talking about the second one?
Yes.
Okay. I thought you were going to go to another page. Go ahead. Sorry.
Consumerism means more uses of materials in the industry. This has been affecting the environment as it causes more wastes. There will always be an effect after an action and on the environmental aspect. Consumerism has caused an ecological imbalance and global warming.
Excuse me. You should actually separate things into pros and cons. Right now, the first one, is it pros or cons of consumerism? Is it the advantage, the benefit of consumerism or not? The first one. Is it a bad impact of consumerism or the good?
It's a benefit
one. The first it's a benefit.
Yes, it's a benefit.
What about the second one?
Is it
a pros or cons? Cons. So I should put it. You should put them like I have shown you already how to do. You have a table showing the pros and the cons so that when people listen to you, they would not mistake a good thing from a bad thing. Because some of them, when they listen to you, they might think, oh, this is a good effect of consumerism. Because you didn't differentiate and make it like clearly divided into the pros and the cons. Okay, so you just say it's the effect. Is it a bad effect? Is it a good effect? You don't make it clear. So that's not as good as if you make it clear cut as to this is a good effect of consumerism on one side. And then the bad side and the bad effects on the other side. You make it clear, you know,
when you make your presentation, okay? Guys, for the rest of the other teams, please listen and make your presentation a little bit clearer than this. Don't combine and put them all together effect. So is it good or bad, you know? It's not clear, but please go on.
Okay.
Let me mention that you don't have any references anywhere on your PowerPoints. This is very important, guys. But okay. That's too late for you. Go ahead.
Okay, I'm sorry. Okay. So there are the consumerism advantages and disadvantages to everyone today.
Oh.
So the advantages of consumerism are as follows in this. So the first thing is consumerism stimulates economic growth. Second is it also boosts creativity and innovation. The third thing is consumerism encourages freelancing, entrepreneurialism, and self-employment. And the last thing is consumers are given more choice in this society. So what about this advantage? So this advantage of consumerism are as follows in this. So the first is increasing demand of goods puts extensive pressure on natural resources, such as water and raw materials. The second is, it changes the moral fabric of society. The third is, consumerism increases debt levels, which in turn results in mental health problems like stress and depression. And the last thing is, the poor are always left behind by consumerism.
You should try to use your own words and not read, okay? Like, for example, if you go back to the previous page, I would read this and then I would try to understand what it is saying. And then I would just tell your friends using my own words by saying that when you try to produce more and more products to sell to consumers, of course, you have to use a lot of natural resources. You use a lot more water, you use more raw materials, and that hurts the environment because you use up all the raw materials in the world, so it's bad for the environment,
yes,
right?
Yeah. Right.
And then when you buy or sell things, you change the society. Would you explain some more about this? Do you understand what this is saying?
So I use example. I use iPhone by Steve Jobs. When Steve Jobs have to present the new iPhone. So this phone is the first smartphone in the world. Mm-hmm. So it's changed the world to use the smartphone.
So. You know, that's why I'm trying to tell you that when you say, don't just put a car, you just mention the topic and then you don't give examples. So people don't understand the point that you're trying to make with the second one. You know, what does this mean? Why change society? How? But if you give this example of Steve Jobs creating newer and better mobile phones, then people now change their habits and they're on the phone all the time, you're saying, right? Because it's so convenient. They buy things on the phone. They contact people on the phone. They do business on the phone. So the way people live now changed just because you have new phones, you see? So that's how societies changed. You don't go to see each other or visit each other as often. You don't go and see, you know, go to the shops more often to, you know, talk to people. In the banks, for example, you don't have to go to the banks. When you go to the banks, you talk to people, you meet the people at the counters, things like that. But now you can do it online. And so the way the society works changes a lot. Okay, with the new things being created to feed
to the consumers. Okay, so that's how you would say, you would talk and give examples and explain. Okay, next step.
Okay, also the next conclusion.
Hmm.
The conclusion of consumerism is consumerism has a good side and a bad side. Although consumerism drives economic growth and boosts innovation, it comes with a fair share of problems ranging from environmental and moral degradation to higher debt levels and mental health problems.
So this our presentation teacher. So I have a question for everyone to discuss.
Why don't you discuss together first? That's what I told you to do, to prepare to talk to each other on the topic.
Yes, teacher, but I have a question to discuss this topic. To everyone.
No, that's not what you do. You are leading the discussion, the two of you. So that's what I told you, the way to do it, because you're involved, both of you, in leading the discussion. So once you present something, you discuss together first before getting us to talk, because once we start to discuss, you will not talk to each other. So we want to know what you think first, the two of you. See, you should have made a script so that you will be talking to each other on the topic first. Haven't you been listening to what I have been telling you what to do?
Okay,
and the previous teams, that's what they're doing. So do you have, you know, first of all, you should give us some idea of what you think, you guys think about this, the two of you. Have you discussed together about this at all? What have you been discussing together about this? So discuss it so that we can hear your discussion and then we can join in, because we want to know first what you think. And then we can say whether we agree with you or we disagree with you, or we have some other information to add. We don't know yet what you guys think. No?
Okay.
What do you guys think?
Do you think there are more consumerist women than men, and why?
Yeah. Consumerism is what the way you define it. You must know. You can't say a girl or woman is is a consumerism. You can't equate. เหมือน บอกว่า ไก่ คือ แมว อย่าง เงี้ย ไก่ cannot be แมว ฮะ มัน different species. You understand? You can't say a woman are more consumerism. Consumerism is a noun, nah? You must understand. So your question is, who are you, by the way? I haven't noted you, Manita. You're trying to ask Supachai whether he thinks that women are more prone to consumerism behavior. Or not, right? More prone to behavior.
I think
that is,
in my opinion, I think it's right. Because
you agree?
Yes, I agree.
Why?
Because I think the woman will want to buy a new collection, some bag or
don't you go and buy things. Come on guys, argue. Manita, you have to argue with Supachai.
I agree with him.
You agree with him? Come on, this is stereotyping. Oh, this is very bad stereotyping, isn't it, Kanta? Someone help me with this. Papichaya.
It's
That's
a
very
stereotyping solid.
Now. Come on, girls are bad because they keep buying things. That's not true. Girls are we save a lot of money, you know, when we are wives. We have to take care of the family.
Yes.
We can be very frugal. Frugal ก็คือ you know เก็บเงินใช้เงินอย่างมีความรับผิดชอบ careful with spending money. We don't have to all be bad. So the way you say women are more. You คือจับเข้าไปในกลุ่มเดียวว่าเป็นหมดเลยอย่างเงี้ยเขาเรียกว่า stereotyping. Okay, which is not a good way, but it's a good topic to discuss. But Pichaya, what were you saying?
Yeah, you were saying all the things that I would say. you say it all like, okay, I don't need to say anything more.
Oh, well, say it in your own word.
It's a very solid point, but I think that many women that are frugal, but frugal, that are not spending all their money for some beautiful stuffs, some clothes or bags. And I think there are many of them too.
Yeah.
That
and would you be able to tell me examples of guys who like, you know, behave in a consumeristic way as well?
There are guys.
For example, what do they buy? Let me go
they
to
buy Gavelin. Some. Oh, okay.
Thank you. You got a point, Gavelin. I want to get your response. What do you think?
I think it's not just like women who buy a lot of stuff. Hmm. Like one of my guy friend, he bought like a lot of shoes and a lot of belts and bags. Too.
You know that their shoes and their bags are more expensive than the girls' shoes and bags.
They are like a lot expensive.
But if you buy a suit, it's so like almost 10,000 baht. When our dress is like sometimes 500 baht only.
Yes, that's
so that's
true.
Why we can buy more. We can buy many of them because they're not expensive. But the girls' pants, trousers, the boys' trousers are each because I have three sons. I know they're very expensive. Okay, so Atsajan, what do you have to say for yourself?
More example for a guy like they're buying a watch that have a brand and apply is like
we won't mention anybody's name, but you can think of someone who has many, many expensive watches.
Yeah, a watch is also expensive
in the news.
Too.
Okay. See, so people would collect watches. Anything else? Very expensive watches. Anything else?
Yeah, and also a car too.
Cars, right? Yeah.
A lot of male like a car.
Yes, and you can have like 10 Mercedes, 10 Mercedes Benz. One in black, one in blue, one in red, one in yellow, one in green.
Yeah.
One in blue. You know, they collect them all. Yeah. Papai, you want to argue with that? Or Pakin, you should argue with that. Defend yourself. Pon Papai. Pon Papai. Oh, where are you? Pon Papai. Pon Papai. No? Pakin. Pakin, yes.
Could you repeat that again?
No. You should be trying to attend to our discussion. But what?
I believe that the guy is also consumerism, right?
Consumeristic.
Because like for someone who obsessed with headphones and high quality audio, like
that's true.
In Japan, there's a man who like bought the electric pole for their house. And it costs like he bought the electric pole for himself.
Oh my goodness.
That which costs like more than cars or anything else.
But so now everybody is saying that guys are as bad as girls. Bantita, do you agree with that? Oh, sorry, I skipped over Jinawat. Let's go to Jinawat first.
Okay.
Yes, I agree. I would say that I cannot tell exactly that between men and women that which one is which the one worst. Are better. Yes. So
you're saying because, they're equally bad?
Yes, because I've seen all those people that are the consumerists. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
What do you think about the Thai society, though? Do you think that we are too prone to consumerism, the Thais? Or we are reasonably, careful with the way we use our money? What do you think? Bantita.
According to what I see, like mostly of my friends, I think we are quite consumerism. Like
consumeristic.
Some people just wear clothes once and they just like don't wear it again. It's still right. Up to the person. Like
you think so, but maybe because you're in the high society. Don't take an offense. I'm trying to make an argument. Because if you are in a poor family or come from a family that is not so well-to-do, then they would be more careful with money. But if you walk around with, people from high society, you will see them using a lot of money uselessly. They would sort of buy Gucci bags when they would buy a lot of expensive stuff, shoes and bags and everything, just because they're limited edition and, they're very hard to find, things like that. So maybe it depends on the society in which you circulate, maybe. Huh? Kanta?
Yes, I think that some people might not be materialistic, but they think that it's a good investment. For example, like Birkin bags, like Hermes bags, the price like tends to go up over years. It goes up like faster than cash. So some people invest in it.
Good side, some good idea that I didn't think of. So I'm gonna give you 2 points. Natsariya. So it could be an investment. What do you think?
I still think the girl is more consumeristic.
Why do you think it's a girl?
Okay, think about just the outfit normal. So as you can see, the girls have a lot more things than the boy, especially their shirts and the blouse, but we still have the underwear.
I see. But they don't wear guys don't wear underwear. They do wear underwears too.
They do wear, but I just said the girl is more pieces than the boy.
Many more pieces.
Than
the
boy.
The boys will go to bed naked, for example.
Accessory or something.
So they don't need pajamas, maybe.
even pajamas, maybe some boys, they just wear just the bottom part, they don't wear the top part, something like that.
It's so they sort of one suit, they can wear it all the time, every day, and just change the shirt. And they don't need that many shirts, you say. Right? They change because they just have one white and one blue first or something. And then when you wear it, nobody would know that it is not new. It's not newly washed. So you don't need to wash it very often either. So that you keep wearing the same shirt. So you don't need that many of them. Okay, good point. Naramon.
Yes. On my view,
I think both women and men also
give me an example.
For example, my brother, my older brother, he is so fashionable.
So fashionable. Fashion conscious.
Yes. So he spent a lot of money to buy stuff, outfits, or also the thing that he interested to at that time.
Mm-mm. My son spent a lot of money on health stuff, like, you know,
protein, yes,
things like that. He would order a lot online. You know, he keep fitting.
My brother interested in photography.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and he spent a lot of money on cameras.
But you know, they would say, you know, their collections of these things are like more useful. They can argue. But you know, buying clothes, more and more clothes, is like useless, because why do you need that many of them? But anyway, we're gonna get to Parkin, last person, Parkin, because I don't think he gave me the answer. So let's
line our follow up. Yeah.
Okay.
I think it's not depend on the gender you have, but it depends on society, for my opinion. It's like sometimes we have to be consumerism, because like in that society we have to have this thing and this thing to be feel the same like older people, for my opinion. It doesn't depend on gender. It's like everyone just normal man, but they want to enter in that society.
Yeah. To be accepted by that society.
Accepted.
Very good point. And the term for that is peer pressure. Peer pressure, you get 2 points, yes.
Yes, thank you.
So I was going to ask you whether you think it is because of peer pressure or not, but I didn't have to ask that question because Parkin said that for me. So that might be the cause. What do you think? Do we blame peer pressure for the consumerism behavior that, you know, we are developing into a lot? Is it because of peer pressure? What do we blame? That's my question. What do we blame? Who do we blame? Pawat, do you have an answer for me?
I think it's we need to blame ourselves.
Blame yourself.
Because we choose to buy it or not. And some do think that higher quality of product comes with a higher price. So they tend to buy more expensive stuff. Or like camera, you cannot compare the 2,000 baht camera to a 200,000 baht camera, because the quality is really different. So it depends. It also depends on which group, which interest that like.
So you actually think that it is up to you to control yourself, control your urges. Even though you want to fit in to a certain group and they all do this, if you don't wear this expensive cloth or, you know, hold a Gucci bag or whatever, expensive bag, then they would not accept you into their famous and popular group, then that's okay. You should not try to fit in. That's what you're saying?
Yes, you should go to fit in another group, because
it's individualistic, but then you might be bullied.
There are some groups that will accept you, accept who you are.
But some other group would accept you as you are.
Yes.
Okay. But then, okay, thank you. That's one good thing that, you know, you should say, you should, you know, control your urges and not be influenced by your peers.
Next, what else do you think we should blame? I mean, okay, we could resist this urge, but then it's so difficult to resist the urge to buy. Why? Anyone? No one wants to. Pupachai and Manita, you should join in the discussion. It's your responsibility to be involved in my our discussion of this topic. So, Parkin is saying that we should blame peers. You know, the society is forcing us to behave the same way. Whatever they like, whatever they think is popular,
I think for my opinion, we shouldn't blame anything, but just ourselves that choose to go to that sweet situation. I think
no, but really, sometimes it's very hard. Sometimes very hard to resist. Tanya Thorn.
I think maybe parents.
No, parents, why?
Like, if we were raised with, like, money.
Okay.
Like, we can buy everything that they allow.
Okay. So the parents should teach you better. And not just give you too much money. Whatever you ask for, then they would allow you and give you money to go and buy. So you blame some of the parents too. The blame should go to the parents as well. Gavelin?
I think it depends on the groups of friends you're with too. Like if they use like a high-end brand and if you really want to fit in that group of friends you want to. So maybe you feel like the pressure that you must have the same thing as they do as well.
But that's what Parkin said, you know. He said, he mentioned this point already. So why don't you sort of like expand on it by maybe giving an example of your own?
Like when I was in the US,
mm-hmm.
some of my friends at school, they have like Gucci bag and they brought it to school every day. And there was like a friend that really want to be in that group of friends.
Uh-huh.
So she just like really asked her parents like for money or like to buy that thing. Yeah.
Yes. So fitting in is a very important thing. You could think about what you guys are doing. To try to fit in, you have to go and look inside and look at yourself, you know? Whether the things that you are doing is because you want to be like, you know, the society that you move around in, or just because you think it's like the hairdo, the way you hold hair, or, you know, the way you dress, things like that. Is it very heavily influenced by, you know, what your friends and the group that you're trying to fit in or not? What else should you blame? Yes, Super Chai.
I think why we want to blame other person, which one is the parents, the friends? Why didn't blame yourself? Because if you can control yourself to not to buy something, you will not have that problem.
Yes, that's a good argument, Super Chai. But I would argue back like this. I would say that because you can do it, because you have a lot of money, and so you say, okay, I have this money left because my parents are rich. Why shouldn't I buy it? You see? How would you explain? How would you argue with that? What do you think? But it's our money.
I did not say. I did not say money. your
Let me tell you an example, Subhachai. Like people,
if I have a lot of money, I will buy something I like and I want it. But if that situation I did not have money, a lot of money, I will control myself to not buy this thing because if
and
I
what
buy,
would you do with the money
in the future?
What would you do with the money?
Deposit in a bank.
Come on, guys. I expect better from you. I expect a better answer from you. I've already talked. Why don't you go? I don't know who's next now on this list because you didn't lower your hand. Papichaya.
Yes.
Yes. So you have a lot of money to spare. So, you know. Because if you buy more, they can sell more, and there would be more jobs for people.
Yes, that's
the argument. Because when you support all these people selling you stuff, you are supporting the economy. If you stop buying, they can't sell, the economy would not grow, and people would not get jobs. That's the argument that I can make. So what do you think about that? Anybody would like to argue with me on that point? Yes?
Can I? Mm-hmm. In my opinion, I think consumerism it couldn't be a problem if the person have a well-managed of money.
Mm.
Like if they would like to buy a lot of stuff, but it's still in their budget.
Yes.
And they manage it correctly.
Mm.
It shouldn't be wrong then.
Because I'm a rich person. I have a rich parent. I have rich parents. So I have a lot of, you know, stipends to, you know, I have a lot of money to spare. So why don't I spend it to buy these things so that I can support this company and the company can go and hire more people. Or I get people saying, this is the money I save up. So why can't I buy whatever I want or spend it on like a Korean pop group like BTS? When they take over, right? All these girls go and attend their concerts. They will spend money to buy the tickets.
Is this your right to happiness by spending your money?
That's what you are saying. That's what they're saying. And they would go to the airports and scream for the...
As long as you have
on the planes,
the spare for your life, and that's not gonna affect your life, you can spend as much as you want, something like that.
So okay, that's what you say. So then I'm gonna argue you back.
Anyone would like
to? Times up, bro.
Yeah. Yes.
Well, but I'm gonna argue back a little bit. You know that. Papichaya, some can argue with you and say that while you are supporting this business by buying their stuff, you are supporting the worsening of the climate. You're participating in global warming because these companies will use more resources, natural resources, to create all these products to sell to you. So that is one argument against what you were saying, but we don't have the time to spend any more. Yes, because the time is up for this group, I think.
But I want to show something that's special to you. Can I show it?
Okay.
this work is so good. My teacher will be proud for my work.
Go, go.
That is all that is I want to show to you. Thank you so much, teacher.
Okay, thank you very much. All right. You have to join my other activities and you will see more of me in action. But not in this class. Anyway, maybe we can go and have a 10-minute break right now, okay? And then we'll come back to the second team, the second topic of discussion. 10 minutes. All right, so let's go on to the next group. Next team, please come up.
Hello everyone, my name is Sutta Patithan Wawong, student code 6305762.
My name is Panita Pataraku, student code 6305531.
Today we would like to talk to you about military industry and warfare. But before we start listening, we want you to watch our prepared video clip and role play.
Hello, this is ABC News. Now, there is a terrorist insurgency taking place in the margins of our country, but the situation is not very harsh because our country is well protected. We will surely go through about this problem.
You can come in.
Please follow me, Commandant.
Please sit down. What do we have to report?
Right now, the problem in the area is getting harder and harder because our weapons and personnel are not insufficient to defend the country. I think we should urgently accelerate the military industry to manufacture and purchase additional weapons.
I don't allow it because from the fact that I have been reported on the situation of the men of the country, we have not faced that much problem. And I think this little problem shouldn't be the cause of the war. Besides, we don't have that big budget.
But now, the situation has changed. You must be aware of the safety of our country as well.
But I think it's a waste of the budget for a reason. Anyway, I'll try to think about that.
Yes, sir.
This is ABC News. Currently, the situation in our country is very worrying. The terrorists have successfully invaded our country after we received the report. We saw that there were weapons and bombs coming in.
What do we have to report?
Commander, right now the situation is not fine. I think we have to do something. Now, we can't handle it because we don't have powerful enough weapon to tackle this problem. What should we do? You must hurry to decide. If more slower, I'm afraid that I will not catch up.
Okay then, for the peace of our country, take it as you have proposed.
Yes, sir.
This is ABC News. From star performance, at this time the border situation has returned to normal state.
Hello. Guys, I think you might have missed the point of the topic of your discussion. When we talk about the military industry, this is a global problem, right? We're talking about global issues, and this is about countries building armament, war armory, like bombs or machine guns or missiles and things like that, or submarines or anything that you can use to fight war, to sell to other countries like Thailand or Syria or Lebanon or Afghanistan, or these people or these countries in which they are fighting. Okay? Countries like the US or the UK and Russia and also China, they are involved in military industry. They have an industry that they profit from selling weapons two people who are fighting together in other countries, fighting each other in other countries. So they benefit from warfare. This is not about one country trying to defend oneself by building their own factory to build guns and weapons to defend its country, its own country. That's not what we're talking about. Military industry now, it's a world problem because a lot of countries are benefiting a lot. They have a lot of billions and billions of income into their country from selling these military weapons, you see, to other countries. Yes. And that's the problem that we're discussing today. Not because not about, you know, whether we should build our own factories to build our own guns to produce, to create our own weapons or not, because we have some problems of our own in our country. No, that's not a global problem. That's a local problem. And the global problem is now. You don't know that all these world power are actually benefiting from wars, and they are being blamed. A lot of people are saying these countries are supporting people, trying to get people to keep on fighting, because if there are no wars, they can't sell their weapons. They will lose billions and billions of dollars every year selling weapons to the groups that are against the government of this government, like in Lebanon or in Syria or in Yemen. There are factions fighting, right? Where do they get the money from? One faction will get their weapon from Russia. Another faction fighting with each other, they are getting military weapons from the US and the UK. They are benefiting a lot from all these wars, and people are saying that's why they don't want the war to end. See? And I think you are missing the point in your role play. Okay? So I hope that your video will be more to the point. So let's see your video clip. Can you show me our video clip, your video clip now?
Human history has been full of battles and wars, some big and some small. But if World War III were to happen, it might be humanity's biggest battle yet. Advanced technology, massive troops, and more intensive strategy would all be involved. But why would something like this happen? What countries would join in? And how would this war be fought? This is What If, and here's what would happen if we had World War III. People have talked about a possible World War III for decades. It almost started in the 1960s during the Cold War between Russia and the United States, but thankfully we managed to avoid that. But let's say we aren't lucky enough to avoid it next time. When might World War III happen? Well, it's tough to say. A world war could start due to prominent political figures getting killed, intelligence threats, or fighting over valuable resources. Talking about it like this makes the chances of a war happening sound likely, but the chances are actually a lot lower than you think. Since 1945, the world has seen many different battles. Vietnam, Afghanistan, and dozens of different civil wars. We should keep in mind that in order for a world war to happen, it needs to involve the entire world. And the structure of the world has changed even more since 1945. Countries simply aren't as closely allied as they used to be. Militaries are even stronger and more skilled than they were. As in previous world wars, it's most likely that millions of people would die, and the Earth would take decades, if not centuries, to recover, especially with some of the weapons and tools countries would be using in today's age. soldiers on the ground might have exoskeletons. These are metal frames around the soldier's body that augment their strength. Although this probably won't turn them into RoboCop, it would make it easier for soldiers to carry heavy equipment over long distances. Weapons that can bend around corners might also be a possibility. And instead of seeing the war fought in the sea or the sky, it could actually be fought in space. Militaries could fight over weaponized satellites that could affect what's below them. Although a lot of this stuff sounds like something out of a sci-fi movie, we should keep in mind that these weapons are scary, and hopefully no one will ever need to use them. After all, things like this are meant to kill people. But there may not be many soldiers on the ground. The war of the future might be fought on computers. Drones, artificial intelligence, and robots could be the only things on the battlefield. There's also a chance that acts of war in the future might not involve any violence at all. Hacking into other countries' computers, as well as power grid shutdowns, are all a possibility. And what would this war be about, anyway? It could have to do with resources, specifically water. Since fresh water is such a scarce yet valuable resource, nations may begin to fight over it as it continues to deplete. Hopefully, World War III won't go on forever. So how could it end? Well, one reason, and a main reason why a world war hasn't happened yet, has to do with these things. During World War II, the United States dropped nuclear bombs on Japan, killing over 100,000 people. The cities involved took decades to recover. But the two nukes used in World War II would pale in comparison to the modern nukes we have today. Oh, and by the way, there are nearly 14,000 nuclear warheads around the world, held mostly by America, Russia, and China. A nation can have all the resources, people, and strategy they want, but if a nuke gets dropped on them, then it's game over. And if one country drops a nuke, what's to stop another country from doing the same? And then another, and another, and soon the world would be destroyed. So who would win this war? Absolutely no one. A full-on World War III would have a massive impact on the world as a whole. It's safe to say that the world would never be the same. But try not to lose sleep over this. After all, a third world war like this, with dozens of countries involved, is incredibly unlikely to start tomorrow. If two countries get into a fight, it's more likely that other countries that aren't directly involved will stay that way and let the other nations fight for themselves. Wars are terrible. Let's try to avoid them.
Okay, I hope you're making a connection between the military industry and warfare. Because I put them together, that means that I want you to talk about the connection between the two topics. You seem to be talking about one thing and then the other thing, warfare. What is the connection? I hope you prepared to talk to tell us that. Please go on.
So we're going to talk about the topic of military industry and the warfare. First, I will talk about the definition. Military industry is a global industry which that manufactures or sell weapons and develop military technology.
It's a global industry, guys. It's not just in one country. Not to defend oneself, one country. It is a global industry involving many, many countries. They create, they build the weapon in one country, but they sell it to many, many other countries. And they make millions and billions of dollars about it. Go ahead.
A driving factor that behind the relationship between the government and defense mining corporation is that both sides benefit one side from obtaining more weapons.
You have to talk more loudly. It's very difficult to hear you.
and other from being paid to supply them.
Warfare refer to the common activity and characteristic. Warfare refer to the common activity and characteristic of type of war or of war in general. Total war is warfare that is not limited to purely lawful military target and can result in Syrian or other non-combatant suffering and cruelty.
And the main cause of warfare, first one is economic gain. Like often wars are caused by one country wish to like take control of another country with whatever the other reason for way maybe, there is like almost always an economic motive underlying the most conflict. Even if the state aim of the war is presented to the public as something more worthy. Like for example, in Finnish and Soviet war, or it is called Winter War in 1939 to 1940. The Stalin and Soviet army wanted to mine nickel and the area of Finland, but the Finland was refused and the Soviet Union went to war with the country.
Number two, religion. Religion war can often be tried to other reasons for conflict, such as nationalism or even for a perceived historical site in the past. For example, the Crusade in 1095 to 1291. The Crusades were a civil war sanctioned by a Latin church during the medieval age. The aim of Crusades was to expel Islam and spread Christianity.
Third, revenge. Like seeking to punish just a complaint for a perceived slight can often be a factor in the waging of war. Revenge also relates to like nationalism as the people of a country which has been wrong are motivated to fight back by foreign spirit. Like for example in World War I, the extreme loyalty and nationality caused many countries to become involved in the First World War.
And number four, nationalism. Nationalism in this context accessory means attempting to prove that your country is superior to another by violent subjugation. This often takes the form of an invasion. For example, World War II in 1939 to 1945, the rise of the Nazi Socialist Party and Germany is eventual domination of the European continent were direct result of the Treaty of Versailles, which imposed strict punishment on Germany.
The relationship between military industry and warfare is like the military industry, they still provide weapons for the country that is for dealing with violent events or wars. And if the military industry is not prepared, the weapons for war in the future, it could result in the collapse of the country. And at the same time, the military industry is one of the things that add to the violence and conflict involved if not thought carefully before taking action.
You are restricted the term military industry only to one country protecting itself, you see. But that's not it. It's a global one. We are talking about global issue. not domestic issue. Okay, so the purpose, they might say it's for protecting its own country, but no, actually, they're selling these things to other people to fight with each other in other countries around the world. Okay, please go on.
The next topic is advantage and disadvantage of warfare.
Advantages and disadvantages.
Advantages.
Oh, car. Advantages, not advantage. Advantages.
Advantages and disadvantages of warfare. Advantages of warfare. Economic growth. We war can strengthen an economy by providing jobs also. War allow manufacturing to try, especially weapon and ammo manufacturing. In terms of conflicts, more people buy weapon and ammo and touch more money thanks hand, which benefit the people serving the weapon and boost the economy.
Next, technological advancement. Like the competition and conflict tend to lead to nations trying to develop better technology than their opponents. Let's think of the accelerated progress in flying technology by the year 1900. We barely had any of it, but by the time when World War II had ended, we had fully functional planes. Also, the technology that is created can still be useful after the conflict is over.
Can you give me more examples? More concrete examples that actually impact us? Advances, technological advances that actually benefits us, people, not fighting people. Pawat, you have your hand up. You want to answer or what? You still have your hand up. So if you don't want to say anything, lower your hand. Lower your hand, please. Chat, somebody chat. Oh, something wrong with your microphone. Okay. All right. So can you give me more concrete examples of the benefits of warfare to us lay people, everybody in the world, not just the fighting countries? More examples. Anyone? Oh, raise your hand again. Pawat, what do you want to say?
It's microwave oven.
From what?
It's from the radar technology. And he found that when he put chocolate near the radar, it melts, so he applied it to the oven.
So if we didn't have war, we wouldn't have microwave oven.
Yes.
So that's one good thing of the war.
Yeah.
Anybody else? See, that's a concrete example. Come on. There are so many. Alcanta. Alcanta, yes.
The benefit of the war,
technological advancement.
Yes, technological advancement, and also it benefits the country that. So
I want example.
So weapons like the U.S. The military and defense industry is a significant economic driver of the U.S. So they try to support and evoke war in other countries, for example, Syria. In Syria, the government.
Is that the pros or cons?
The pros to the country that sell weapons.
No. Yes, okay, but my question is the benefit in terms of technological advancement of warfare. Benefit to us, not the countries fighting with each other. Can you think of any technological advancement that actually we're enjoying right now, Chom Khwan?
GPS.
GPS.
Yes.
GPS to, as a result of what?
As a result of in the war, they have to locate the enemies. Yeah, and it can apply in real life.
Now it is used in what? In a car, yes. So if we didn't have a car, we wouldn't have any GPS. That is very useful, right?
Yes.
Achan. Achan.
No, I just raised my hand. You should ask the other first.
But you came up first. I don't know, because the team is sharing the screen, right? So I only see the hands that just come up first. And you were first on, but now Thanyathorn is first. So I don't know what the cue is anymore if we are in a share screen mode. If we are sharing screen, I don't know who is first in the queue, you see. I mean, I see you first right now. You are on top of the queue. That's why I called you up first. Huh? So you have to stop sharing then, or I can't ask you these questions. Who was first? Who can see the queue? I can't see the queue. I see either Achan or Thanyathorn. Now Thanyathorn is gone. So Achan, tell me, because you're first on my screen.
The warfare caused like some connection to the other country. You can see that in the past, our country Thai have like a bond or a contact to Russia and another country, and it's like.
This means that relationships.
Yeah, it's make relationship to the other country. It make economic better.
Okay.
From knowing the other country.
Thank you, Thanepon.
Yes. Computer is. How do you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Computer is the result of trying to describe the secret code.
Yeah.
Something like
very
that.
Very good. I was waiting for that. Which film is that? That is about this. You know the name, the title of the film.
The who invented computer?
Very good movie.
Alan Turing.
Huh?
Alan Turing. Imitation game, I think.
Enigma.
Yes. Try to describe Enigma.
Enigma.
Yes. I.
So we wouldn't have the computer, or we would still have a very basic, slow computer.
Yes.
Or not very efficient computer to use right now if it was not for the war.
Yes, it's like a catalyst.
Good, Thanyathorn.
Digital camera?
A digital camera, yes.
Like used to...
Why was it for what on the wall?
To spy
To spy on other enemy. Yes. Okay. Gavelin and Gina, what?
Airliners.
Oh, they talked about that already. The team members talk about airlines.
Airplanes.
No, let me go to Gina.
Sanitary napkin.
Huh?
Sanitary napkin.
Sanitary napkin. What was it created for in the war?
It was used to just prevent bleeding.
Gina, what?
Canned food, because
the what? Canned food.
Canned food, yes, because we can't.
That you can preserve.
Yes.
You can preserve food for a long time.
Yes,
and the technique of food preservation was
initiated in the war because you have to transport food for the soldiers in the front line. Okay, so on Uma and then Waratham. I think that's all, okay? We wouldn't have time for the last group.
Like the vitamin. How about, they create like the vitamins, like, you know.
I can't hear you. Can you talk?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
So they create like a vitamin C, you know, supplementary.
Oh, vitamin C.
Yeah,
okay, yes. Yes, to resist all the disease. Waratham, last person.
They create night vision.
Night vision?
Yes, to see the enemy night.
So that when they go into attack, sneak into some place to attack it, then they can do it in the dark, but they can still see the enemy. Okay, those are good. So I will allow the team to finish that presentation and start the discussion very quickly. Don't talk too much. We want to discuss. Go ahead.
The aftermath of winning, of course, was having a result of victory depend from country to country, but generally it means that they avoid suffering under the yoke of another power.
This is a pro of war. Are you sure? Wait a minute. Are you saying this is the pro? The aftermath of war is a pro of war? Let me show you this. Stop sharing, please. Because we get to this point, I'm afraid I have to show you these pictures. Please stop sharing for a while. Superpat and yes. I would like to share my own pictures. My God, where is it? I have to go to this one, I think. And then we all. Are you seeing what I have on the screen?
Yes.
Yes.
I don't know if I put it here or not. Oh no. It's not here. I thought I copied them already. So I'm gonna show you. I'm not sure why I didn't have it anywhere. Okay, so let me show you this picture. You see this? This is the result of the war in Lebanon. Okay, you can see the picture on the right. Lebanon used to be a very beautiful city. And after the war, you see the picture on the left, that's the aftermath of a war, okay? Right.
So I can see the picture.
You can't see it? Why? I think I shared it already. So let me stop sharing and share again. Share. So I click this and then I share. Okay, can you see it now?
Yes, I can.
Yes. So this shows you the before and the after war in Lebanon. Okay, so if you want to start something so that people fight with each other inside the country, and then the other countries outside get involved, like the Russian would support one side and the US would support another side, or the Iran and UAE would support different sides, and then they supply the weapons for you to fight, you know, when you have civil protest and things like that inside your country, the outside people try to make use of your unrest so that they get the country into their side because they want your resources,
like the country like Lebanon or these countries have a lot of resources. So people would like the country to be on their side. So they would support different sides in the conflict. And this is what will happen. How do I switch this one off? Okay, so I switch this off. And I show you, wait a minute. Share again. Lebanon again. Can you see this one? Huh? Guys?
No.
No, I don't.
Answer.
No.
I don't know why. It doesn't work. What am I doing? I don't want this. Switch it off. Why can't I see it? Share screen. And here, and then I go to maybe this one. Not come up. Why can't I see? You can't see this, can you? Can you see this?
I think you need to share the entire desktop.
I have to open it up first. I thought I opened it up, you know, but then it turns out that they're all gone now. So I need to open them all up. Okay, this is Senna. And then I go to this one, say. Okay. And then I go back to share screen. And then, okay, and share. Can you see this? This is Senna, this is in Yemen.
Yes, I can now.
Before the war, it's very beautiful city. A very beautiful city, Senna. And now after the war, it's like this. See? Or, this is about the aftermath. What am I doing? I have another one. I don't do the right thing for some reason. Okay, I have to click this and then share. So, this is also another picture showing a city that's Lebanon before the war and after the war. You see, it's all in ruins because it has been bombed. So, when And all these wars started off from the people themselves coming out on the streets to protest the government. They were not happy with the present government at that time, so they came out to protest on the street and everything. It started off from the Arab Spring. Have you heard Arab Spring? This was, you know, people coming down on the street and protest everything, and they overthrew the government at that time. So everybody thought, oh, we could do that. We can overthrow the government by just coming down on the street and protest everything. But then it led to conflicts in the country. Civil protest leads to civil war inside the country, but it doesn't remain inside the country. Because the countries outside, like the US and Russia and the UK and Iran and Iraq and URE, they all get involved to support different sides to fight. So it actually is called proxy war. Yemen became a country in which a proxy war is fought. They don't fight with each other openly anymore. They just, the US want to fight the Russian, right? They don't fight each other openly anymore. They go and make other people fight within their own country. But each of them will support these different sides with giving them money and military weapons. And this is the industry, military industry, that we are talking about here. Okay, it creates a lot of problem because it creates war within different countries. And many times it just started from civil war inside that country themselves. They have conflict, disagreement with each other. One opposition wants to throw away the other government, and then, you know, it doesn't have its own way. So they went to a country outside and asked them for support to fight with the army of that government, something like that. So,
excuse me
for interrupting. Yes.
We should move.
So let the teams finish up. You want to finish up? Hello? Yes. Finish up, please. Make a conclusion, and why don't you ask us questions? Because I don't think you actually got to the point, you know.
I'm sorry about that.
It's a relationship between the military industry and war. That's what you're supposed to, let go to the conclusion. I've seen this page already, okay? I've seen it. So go to the conclusion page. Yes. Go ahead.
Finally, I will summarize my presentation. The military industry and warfare. War support is also survival. We should encourage the military industry that produce weapons to protect the peace of the country for not causing the war conflicts.
No. The question is, should we support the military industry? After all, I have been talking and telling you about military industry is supporting war between countries and inside countries, the conflict that we are having in many, many countries like Yemen and Lebanon. This is helped along by the military industry. So you should not be telling us to encourage military industry. Don't you think that it is creating a lot of problem to the world, the military industry? Because they are building advanced military weapons to sell to other countries so that they fight with each other. You can't make this position. Don't take side when you lead a discussion, guys. You cannot take side. You have to say there are pros and cons of things. Okay? And actually, you cannot say military industry is all good. It's not good. We should not. Why should we encourage? It's not always good. It has a good side, but it has also a lot of bad side. And that's what you should say in your conclusion, guys. อย่าไปข้างใดข้างหนึ่งขอพูดภาษาไทยนะคะเวลาที่เธอ lead discussion นะคะ supposed to be in the middle อย่าไปบอกว่าฉันอยู่ทั้งนี้หรือทั้งนั้นให้ support military industry อย่างเงี้ยไม่ได้เพราะเธอเป็นคน lead discussion เธอต้องบอกว่าMilitary industry มันมีทั้งกูทั้งแบด it can have a lot of this of advantages but it can lead to very bad things people killing each other we have refugees fleeing from the war and they're starving everywhere they don't have any place to live and that's the next group that is going to be talking about okay so there are both pros and cons don't support one side or the other but anyway what is your question though by the wayLet me see your question, but we can't discuss your question anymore. We just want to know what you want to ask. What is your question?
Like in the global, do we need to have a military industry or not?
Okay, thank you. Next group, please come up.
Don't take sides, okay? All topics have pros and cons. You're supposed to be telling us both sides of the story or more than one side, 360 degrees, and then allow us to make our own decisions. Okay, go ahead. All right. I told you to introduce yourself first. Okay, come on.
No.
You don't introduce yourself first. I don't know who we're talking. I don't know who we're talking right now.
I am Kantarakon Yun Yong and my ID is 6305503.
My name is Tanaka Pandit Amhai. My number is 6305741.
And our topic is mass protest and political instability. Here is our topic.
I can't hear you at all. No sound. Guys, try again. Try again.
A first for these protests, an officer pulled out a gun and shot an 18-year-old protester in the chest. He's still in hospital. Hong Kong's police commissioner lamented all the violence on China's national holiday.
But unfortunately, some rioters choose to do all these sorts of criminal damages.
In fact, all these protests came exactly because it is China's National Day.
They have been corrupting our system for a very long time, and they taking back many of our rights.
The protesters now want democratic rights guaranteed and an inquiry into police brutality. As the police operations continued late into the night, a crowd of regular Hong Kongers, including families, formed to jeer the officers from above.
That's exactly the kind of reaction that the police and the government of Hong Kong has to worry about, because it's not just the protesters who are opposed to the government and who are demanding change. It's really a very broad swath of the community in Hong Kong.
The question is, will that support continue? Sasha Petrusik, CBC News, Hong Kong.
And so a very different scene played out in Beijing today as China celebrated seven decades of communism with a dramatic show of force and fireworks. As you can see, the day began with a military parade through the capital, complete with goose-stepping troops and a display of advanced weaponry, including deep-sea drones and an intercontinental ballistic missile never before seen publicly. The day ended with a fireworks show over Tiananmen Square and some highly choreographed performances, all, of course, designed to send a message of serious strength.
That is our clip. Let's go to the slide presentation. A mass protest is a demonstration is action by a mass of group or collection of groups of people. The political instability is can define in at least two ways. At first, approach is to define it as the propensity for regime or government change. A second is
Regime.
A second is the incident of political and evil. or violence
upheaval
or violence in society, such as assassination, demonstration, and so forth. A third is instability in policies rather than instability in regimes. The form of mass protest can be in four forms. First, it march, which a parade demonstrate by moving along a set route. A rally, which people gather to listen to speaker or musician. Picketing, which people gather to listen to speakers. Which people surround an area and sit in, which demonstrators occupy an area, sometimes for state period, but sometimes indefinitely, until they feel that
infinitely,
until they feel their issues have been addressed, or they are otherwise convinced or forced to leave. The last is nudity, which they protest naked.
Cause of mass protest. One corruption to cost of living. Three, climate justice. For political freedom.
Excuse me, can I buy something? After you're done, video clip, you stop sharing.
There is an echo. I don't know why. We seem to be having a lot of technical difficulties, and then the time is almost up. Better hurry up, guys. We won't have time for discussion on this topic.
Okay. Effect of many protests. Pros. Receive justice from mob protester. Political corruption noticeably reduced. Effect to revolution to way. Understand each order between protester and government. Population can verify operation of government transparent, making the new generations more politically interested and to express their opinion. Stop corruption. Cons. Cause violence in assembly, such as tear gas, health accident and injury. Can't control situation because of many people. Loss of people die if soldier to do daring disregard for human life, open it, fly, or blow it up. No tourism because they are fast of violent. Make GDP decrease in quality and economic depression. Conclusions. Mass protect can aspirate because of many factors, and it also come from political instability. It doesn't only lead to violence. We can do it in peaceful way to success. The agreements and the governments can manage on balance for the better and provide stability. People are ready to accept an agreement and live as peace according to custom and coexistence in society without any effort. Thank you.
Okay. So you're saying that mass protests come from political instability. Isn't it the other way around? Stop sharing, please. What's your question, by the way? I'm going to ask my question at the end of that minute. Huh? What's your question, though?
It is good to do the protest,
Oh, is it good to protest or not on the street, you mean? So you're actually asking the question that I wanted to ask. When you heard about the pros and cons, of course, they told you that there are pros to mass protests and there are cons of being involved in or creating a mass protest or going on to join a mass protest or creating one or starting one. There are pros and cons. Which side do you think are more impressive and would lead you to either join or not join? Which one? I mean, the pros are more convincing or the cons are more convincing to you? Because if you think the pros are more convincing, that means that you're gonna go and join the mass protest, right? But if those of you believe that the cons are more serious, you know, and you believe that, you know, you can have a lot of bad outcome, then you wouldn't join. So which side are you on? Gong Pop?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
I think I will go to join for this.
Mm-hmm. You don't think that actually, I would say, some would say that political instability is the result, not the cause of mass protest. You don't agree that if you have mass protest, then that would lead to political instability and then economic instability, and the economy will just go down the drain and the country would like suffer a lot. And then it's very difficult to control. People will come and support you to fight each other. There will be civil war and then, you know, war and bombing, and you will can't stay in this country. You have to sort of migrate to other countries like in Lebanon or in Yemen. You're not afraid of that?
I think it like a problem in short term, but if the protests like to say what they want,
it is peaceful, you believe that you can keep it peaceful?
Maybe not, but I still think
it's the reason I asked it, because I have seen a lot of mass protests and civil protests and they're never peaceful in the end. It will lead to civil war in all the countries. And maybe that's why the older generations are so afraid of mass protests. You know, I'm not saying it's bad. I'm just saying that, you know, that maybe is the reason why some people would not want mass protests, because they feel, oh, instability, the economy will be bad, and then we can't keep it, you know, there will be violence, and then tourists will not come anymore, the economy will be bad for everybody. That is maybe the reason. But you believe that you can keep it peaceful. I don't know. I'm just never seen one that is peaceful.
Yes, I haven't seen one. Of course, I think.
But you think it's sometimes things is important enough for you to go and voice your concern in the street. It's very important for you to do that. So you have to go. That's what you think. Hemawan. Hemawan.
Yes. I think we have rights to do the protest.
Yes, it's human rights. It's your rights, civil rights.
Yes.
To go on to protest. But of course, you can protest only if you don't hurt anybody else. I mean, you don't block the traffic, for example, or you don't go into some official buildings, like go into a police station to disrupt the court, go into that official building. As long as you don't invade into, you know, other important sites that you're not, you know, their private properties, and the government properties or offices, then it's your right. That's true. Yeah. It's a right. for everyone.
Yes.
To go there, as long as you don't hurt anybody else, right? Ah, okay, good. Achajan. Achajan, yes.
Yeah, I want to say about an economy. You say that when we have a mass protest and economy will decrease a lot. But I have searched about a stock price and GDP in Thailand. When it have a mass protest, a stock price will drop a lot.
The one stock price, yes.
Yeah, after we done the mass protest, it will go up a lot.
Oh, up again.
You can see, yeah, in here.
Okay.
Oh, can you see?
The thing is,
I can show you.
Anyway, I know. Okay,
you can search on the internet.
I don't know whether I can believe that piece of information that you found, but apparently you do.
7 years ago.
But the thing is, I question it because, you know, I know that a lot of businesses from international countries, if they want to invest in Thailand, say they want to build a factory here in Thailand, they would investigate our stability, economic and political stability in the past, say 10 years. They're not going to easily and, you know, one day, decide to build their factory or invest in one country without carefully analyzing the stability in the country. Now, when they see that, you know, people come down to protest in the street and there is always this unrest, people go and burn the building, supermarket, and go and stop a meeting conference. In Pattaya, for example, that's what they did. They went invade into a hotel and stopped the ASEAN meeting, and they have to flee and got in a helicopter and flee back to Singapore and Malaysia and all that. So when they see that kind of thing happening, don't you think that, you know, if you are a clever CEO of a company, they would not invest and put like
in that time, but
for example, Disney.
But in the long term, a mass protest will cause and a people who go out to protest want a country to be better. So in the long term, I feel like it's gonna be better.
You have well intentioned, but don't you think you can change the country peacefully, more in a better way? Not just to go and disrupt everything and create instability like that in the street. Is that other better way? More peaceful way? And, you know, not causing, like, you know, increasing stress in the atmosphere around the country?
I think some problem is hard to solve. So yeah, I think they try to solve it with a peaceful way, but sometimes it not work and some problem is like really hard to solve. So they go out to protest.
Okay. Would you worry?
Yes. I would like to say about the mass protest. It's like people want to explain about something that explain that something happened and is abnormal, so they come to protest.
Yes.
Like something happened in the country and it's...
What if I said the parents are worried that there would be violence because that's what they have seen always in history. That's why.
Yes, but
that
in my opinion,
what do you have in your head? I don't see your face at all. You would be
because like the light is.
Huh? You're using virtual background, I think. We don't see your face. Let me see your mouth, especially, or else I can't understand what you're saying much. Oh,
you can see my mouth.
No, it's very dark. Let me go to Anuma first.
Okay.
So I think if you're saying that, do you hear me? If you're saying that parents like worry about their children, I think so that is the problem because, you know, we go to protest, we use our rights, so the government shouldn't harm us and make
But no, it's sometimes it's not the government. It's a third hand, third party. It's not even the government or it's not your side or anyone. There is a third party that always would like to get the protests going. Like the US, do you know that US has all the hands in all the mass protests around the world? Have you read up this article? Go and read it up. The US financially support all the mass protests that has resulted in all the civil wars in the many countries. So it's not the government, you know. Usually you look at our police and our military in the past, they just stood around. They didn't use their weapon. They didn't even do anything. And when the protesters try to push them away, push the barrier away, they just, you know, couldn't do anything, and eventually they would let the protesters pass. They're very weak and they didn't use any weapon. And those who actually shot at us, a lot of people got killed. I don't know, they are not the command sometimes. Khmer Rouge people hide, they hide high militia. Pendahan no chao tang chat, put tang chat tang dao. That has been hired by I don't know who, okay? So that's why your parents are very worried. They don't know who is gonna like throw a bomb into the protest group or, you know, group of people walking around. That's maybe, I don't know, if I'm talking as a parent, okay? But I know you guys would like to express your opinion.
Yes, I just want to mention about that too. So when people went through the protest and if they got harmed, I just wonder like who, like how that, how the people that went to the protest will got protected by
who will I know be that protected?
Yes, it's like I know that I it's kind of like a
it's not that I didn't get involved in a protest, you know. I sort of understand what you feel, but I did it when I already was working. I had my own income and I was, you know, financially able to support myself, not as a student. Why? Let me tell you my example. My dad kept telling me, okay, it's my duty to work and get a job at my job as best I can to get the money to feed you guys, to take care of my family. That's my job, that's my duty. It's your duty to study. He kept telling me that. It's your duty now to study and then to graduate. And then whatever you go and do, it's up to you. You see, that's your duty. And once I graduated, and I got a job as a teacher. My father told me, it's your job to be a good ajan. Okay? And now you take care of your kids, get a job. See, I have a duty to fulfill. And so that's why I always kept it in my head. His voice always ringing in my ear. And, but sometimes I understand that we had some issues with the government and there is no other way to do it. Yeah, but don't you think, then this is my question, that my dad is sort of correct that, you know, you're now a student and that's your first duty to fulfill? Anyone? Tanta. I'm not saying, you know, it's just the way I was brought up, but you know, you might not
think that
I think it's understandable for parents to be worried about their children because my mom was raised that way as well. She actually told me that she had to take care of her other siblings. So that's why my grandfather was really worried about her to you know, when there were protests going on in the past, you might go to jail for that. You know, some people escaped to actually
And it's not like that now, you know, if you have your picture taken, because you know the media right now, you will never get a job. And that's why they're worried, I think. For you, they're worried for you. They're not worried for themselves. So, you know, because you might not get into any country, you know. You know, when you apply for a visa, there is a question on the application form asking you whether you have ever actively joined a political activity. And if you say yes, you will not get a visa into Australia. This is true. You go and look at the form. And you will not get a visa into the US. Now, if you say no, and they have a way to find out, they will find out that you have been involved in the protest. I'm not scared, trying to scare you, but it is the truth. I have actually encountered this myself, okay? A lot of my friends couldn't get a visa. See? And you don't get a job even, you know, because a lot of companies wouldn't hire you. So maybe, yeah, that's the other thing, argument against it, you know. But I don't, you know, when we are young, we sort of have very strong emotions. Let me hear from Atsadang. Have I asked, I have talked to you or not, Atsadang?
No.
Oh, okay, Atsadang, let me hear from you. But the last person, because the time is up now.
Okay, so, sorry. I just like to add that politics really affect everyone, even you are student or teacher. Because if I am student, but I only live in school for like 8 hours.
Yes.
And then that we are in social, so...
After that, why we the can,
yeah, why we can express our feeling by the, but how we can evolve the politics by that.
I don't know how. It's just that maybe it's not the right time for you. I'm talking instead of, you know, on the side of the parents. Because you're taking the other side, I'm taking one side. If you take the side of the parents, I'm going to take the side of the student. Because I understand both sides. You understand? I understand both sides, but... Yeah, you think that you have ideas about politics. And that's good, you know, because in the past, students are very ignorant. They don't think that they should care about politics or go to vote or who to vote and things like that. So we have come a long way, but if more freedom, when a society has more freedom, then we have more danger. It's more dangerous. It's harder to control, I think. But anyway, thank you for joining in the discussion. The time's up. So let's go. But before that, let me take a picture. How do we go from here? Okay, all right. Now, can I just get a... capture the screen once more. So smile, guys, everyone.
Thank you, teacher.
It's a big topic to talk about and we don't have enough time. Sorry about that. So go and think about it. As long as we think about it, that's okay. And you make your own decision.
Teacher, I have a question.
Okay, don't blame me that I'm...
Okay. Just a little question.
Okay,
Is ignorance bad?
Is ignorance bad?
Yeah.
Who asked me this? Who is asking me this?
Me, yeah.
Papita, yeah. I think if you ask me, well, I should not tell you what I think. I should ask you this. Don't you think it is bad? Don't you think it is bad? I mean, you know, you always ask things as a question. I make it into a question so that you don't impose your opinion onto some other people, which is sometimes bad because the other people would sort of be upset with you for trying to impose your ideas onto them. So I'm gonna say, isn't it bad? It could be bad because if you are ignorant of the truth and you don't hear about all the truths or the real stuff or listen to both sides, then when someone comes and tell you one side, which may not be true, then you immediately believe it because you have not thought about or you have not heard or tried to find out about that subject before. So it could be very dangerous, don't you think? Ignorance. So I think it's better that you find as much information about everything so that when somebody talks about this, you sort of, oh, but it could be like this. Oh, maybe not. Maybe it's like this. And you have a wider vision. You see the world clearly and you can sort of argue yourself and make the right decision whether you believe the guy or not. You could be led into doing things that are not very clever. You know, if you're ignorant and you don't know that there are a lot of bad people around, for example, you know, a lot of innocent people believe that. And maybe making some of you guys unhappy in my class because I try to, you know, get you to see all the problems in the world and everything. But don't be so serious, I mean, you know, and say, oh, Daniel Wimon's class is so, I'm so unhappy because she told me all this hardship and poverty and people starving in the world and all that. But I think that's why I try to get you to discuss these serious problems because I think that ignorance not, well, I would say that it has worse repercussions than knowing. Not knowing is, I don't know, maybe worse than knowing too much. What do you think?
Huh? Okay, thank you. I think knowing is better than not knowing anything.
Okay,
it's okay. So, thank you.
Okay, good. Good. Have a good day, everyone. You can relax now. Bye-bye.
Thank you, teacher.
Bye.
Thank you, teacher.
Thank you.
Thank you, teacher.
Thank you, teacher, for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you, teacher. See you again next week. Bye.
See you next week. Thank you, teacher. Thank you.
Thank you.
Got two chats here. I didn't read teach. Oh, okay. Somebody was sleeping. Somebody was eating a lot and getting me to feel hungry. Somebody was eating all the time.
ค่ะอ่าพอเป็นโค้ชเนี่ยก็เอามือเด็กลงให้นะคะอาจารย์เวลาเด็กตอบเสร็จแต่ว่าพออาจารย์ถามคำถามใหม่น้องคนเดิมยกมือค่ะอาจารย์เลยคิดว่าน้องอยากยกมือลงใช่ค่ะคนเดิมเขาอยากตอบหลายรอบค่ะอ๋ออย่างตอบแล้วโอเคขอบคุณมากค่ะเพราะว่าครูนึกว่าเขาตอบไปแล้วนี่ก็เลยไม่ได้ไม่ค่ะเอามือลงให้อยู่ค่ะแต่ว่าน้องอยากตอบอีกค่ะ
โอเคค่ะขอบคุณมากเลยค่ะ been a great help bye ค่ะ bye bye